Hey guys, I'm Michael, and today we are going to take a look at what's inside my camera bag. All right, to be honest, I really don't know what's in here. I haven't checked in a long time, but I know at least a few things that I know are gonna be in here. So let's see. So first, my camera bag. I'll take out some of the heavy stuff first. Have laptop, of course. Okay, let's get into the important stuff, the stuff that you guys actually care about. So first, most importantly, the camera, the Fujifilm X-H2S. I love this camera. It has like a screen that you can kind of flip out, you know, so you can kind of frame yourself. I think that's important when you're kind of shooting, especially by yourself. What I love about this camera is that it shoots up, you know, shoots 4K. If you're doing video up to 60 frames, for slow-mo, and you can actually go up to 120 frames a second, but it's a cropped kind of like a video. But this is also a APS-C sensor camera. But you know, full disclosure, this was loaned to us by Fujifilm, and we have to give it back, which is also sad. Please, Fuji, don't take it away from me. You know, I really love it. If you want to gift it to us, that would be great, but either way, you know, so we'll send it back if you want us to. Also, the lens that they loaned to us as well, 16 to 80 millimeter lens. What's great about this combo is it has optical image stabilization, and this also has an in-body image stabilization. So just that combo, when you put it together, when you're filming something, if you're trying to run and gun, it's a dream. Honestly, so having that steady video is important. Let's see what else is in here. Camera strap, you know, by Peak Design, you know, with quick releases. This is something I always enjoy and love. This is something I also have. Sometimes when you're running and gunning, you just have a quick mic to kind of shoot on the go. And obviously the wind muff or the dead cat is there. I have some ND filters here to make sure that when on those really sunny days, I have something that can, you know, help with the ISO and where you can't crank your shutter speed so high or low, when especially in those photos. This is a huge mess, but I have, even though we have a wireless lav mic kind of, you know, on me right now, you never know. Sometimes if your battery dies, this is a wired lav mic that has been used many, many times, honestly, in very clutch moments. So having that here, let's see what else is in here. Some USB to USB-A to micro cables and charging. Let me put this to the side because that's not good. I have two mini LED lights here that I've used on many, many shoots where I just need to do a hair light or I need to light a product. And these are battery powered, so you don't need to have this charged, or you can plug it in directly, but having this, or you can use AA batteries, but you know, it has like the kind of like the amber tone that you can kind of quickly put off. It's magnetic, or if you just want the clear version here, but having two of these has been very, very clutch and helpful. So I'll put these over here. What else? I have another lens here. This is a, oh, that's bad. Yeah, don't, hold on, give me a second. You know what? I'm not gonna pick this up. Just for the sake, I will let this be open. But I have a Sigma lens, Sigma mount with a Canon lens. It's 17 to 70 at f/2.4 to 4. This is something I use sometimes when I'm using my other camera when I have multiple shoots. So just having another angle is helpful as well. I have other lenses here. I actually don't know what's actually in here. So actually a case within a case. I'll move this. So I have the Nifty 50, which I'm sure a lot of you know. This was the first lens I ever purchased for my other camera. And just having this here, I shot a lot of portrait photos with this, a lot of shots on the beach as well. So this was something I started out with. I think I even keep this as kind of like a reminder of where I started, even though I started on a film camera, but this is something that I actually don't use this ever. I just have this here. Maybe I can't let go. But I'll kind of put this behind here. And then another kit lens for the other camera, so I kind of will put that back there as well. Okay, let's see. I have a flash. I actually haven't used this flash in about 5 years because I'm always kind of in the studio with continuous light, or I find myself shooting a lot of natural lit kind of like shots, just because I just enjoy them more. But I'll put that here as well. What else? A lot of caps. A lot of caps actually. Let's see what's on the side. I have our SanDisk SD card holder that I created. Just by the way, fun fact, I designed this. So if you guys are out there using it, it was me. So, and I'll kind of put this over here. Hopefully you can see, maybe not, I don't know. Oh, okay, this is pretty important. This is the SanDisk Extreme Pro Portable SSD. Version 2 has the heatsink here, as you can see from the aluminum frame, you know, with the speed and the way we're kind of shooting, especially when we're doing on the field kind of shots and videos, we need to have a backup. Though I put it on the laptop as well, you know, to have an additional backup just in case is crucial, as you guys understand. You just never know. This is becoming a huge mess, actually. Hopefully you guys are enjoying this lens cleaner. A gray card here, just so I can do white balancing as well. I'll put this here, like micro SD card holder thing, just because I should really put it in the SanDisk SD card holder case, actually, that I made. So yeah, this has been What's in My Bag. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it, and we will see you next time. Bye.